Good morning students, welcome back to saradamathschannel. In this video I am posting the most important essay question from the topic tangent normal applications of derivatives from the topic Maths1B. Okay, this is the most important essay question and this is the question given in the pre-final examination, so 2022. So most important question, all of you listen the question. If the tangent at any point on the curve x power 2 by 3 plus y power 2 by 3 is equals to a power 2 by 3 intersects the coordinate axis in the points A and B, then show that the length AB is constant. Okay, so what is the question? Show that the length AB is constant. We have to show that length is equals to constant. So here, what are A comma B? If the tangent at any point at the curve intersects the coordinate axis at A comma B, so that is, first here I am taking the given curve here. What is the curve given here? X power 2 by 3 plus y power 2 by 3 is equals to a power 2 by 3. Okay. So at any point on the curve, suppose P is any point on the curve, the tangent at any point on the curve, this is the tangent of the curve at the given point. What is given? The tangent intersects the coordinate axis at the points A, comma B. So these are the coordinate axis. This is the tangent of the curve. The tangent intersects the coordinate axis at the points A, comma B. So the question is, show that the length AB is the constant. We have to show that this length is equals to constant. For that, first what we want? We want these two points. Since this is the intercept form, I am taking the points A, comma B as A is equal to A, comma 0 and B is equal to 0, comma B. Okay. Since this is the tangent in the intercept form, so these two points are a comma 0 and 0 comma b. Okay, see here. So first we want the equation of the tangent. So what is the equation of the tangent formula? In general, the equation of the tangent formula is y minus y1 is equals to m into x minus x1. What is m? Slope of the tangent. How to find the slope of the tangent? By taking the derivative of the given curve. Okay, this is the tangent. So after getting the tangent, you have to convert the tangent in the intercept form. And what is intercept form? X by a plus 5 ab is equals to 1. Okay, after that, take the values a comma b and replacing the a comma b values in the points, finally in the last step you have to find the ab length value. Okay, that is the processor. Okay, what is m here? Dy by dx. What is the equation of the tangent? Y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. What is the line in the intercept form? X by a plus 5b is equals to 1. So first we want the slope of the tangent and equation of the tangent and intercept form of the tangent. After getting this one, you have to take the two points and finding the distance ab. Okay, this is the processor. Okay, let us start the solution. So first here I am writing the given curve. So curve given here is x power 2 by 3 plus y power 2 by 3 is equals to a power 2 by 3. And after that I take one point px1, y1 in this curve. That is, let p is equals to x1, y1 be any point on the curve. Okay. Since it is a point on the curve, it satisfies the curve equation. Okay, since px1, y1 is a point on the curve, the point satisfies the curve equation. Therefore, x1 power 2 by 3 plus y1 power 2 by 3 is equals to a power 2 by 3 is equation 1. Simply, since it is a point on the curve, I am substituting that point in the curve equation. Okay, so what next? Again, taking the curve equation here and doing the derivative to get the value of the slope value. Okay, again I am taking here the given curve. Now differentiating with respect to x, just I am doing the derivative, so to find the slope value, so differentiating with respect to x. Okay, what is x power 2 by 3 derivative? This is x power n form, n into x power n minus 1, that is 2 by 3 into x power 2 by 3 minus 1. Again, this is also x power n form, n into x power n minus 1, 2 by 3 into y power 2 by 3 minus 1 into again y derivative dy by dx is equals to This is the constant and the constant derivative is equal to 0. Okay. Exponent and into exponent minus 1. Exponent and into exponent minus 1. But here in place of x we have the y. Again doing the derivative of that y, that is dy by dx. Okay. So 2 by 3 into x power 2 minus 3 minus 1 by 3. Just doing the LCM. Plus 2 by 3 into y power, here also 2 minus 3, that is minus 1 by 3 into dy by dx is equal to 0. Okay. Now we want the dy by dx value, that is writing the first term to the right side. So this is 2 by 3 into y power minus 1 by 3 into dy by dx is equals to minus 2 by 3 into x power minus 1 by 3. Writing this value to this side. Now cut the 2 by 3 constant on both sides here. So the value of the which implies y power minus 1 by 3 is nothing but 1 by y power 1 by 3. Okay. Just I take the minus symbol as 1 by. 1 by y power 1 by 3 is equals to here also minus x power minus 1 by 3. Just remove this minus and take the fraction. Minus 1 by x power 1 by 3. Now we want the dy by dx value. Therefore dy by dx is equal to writing this value to this side. So this becomes minus y power 1 by 3 by x power 1 by 3. So this is the slope of the tangent. Therefore we are substituting the point in this value. Slope at x1 y1 is equals to, okay, that is substituting the point x1 y1 in this value. Dy by dx is equals to minus y1 power 1 by 3 by x1 power 1 by 3. Therefore this is the slope of the tangent. Therefore slope of the tangent m is equals to, we have to find the derivative value, and in the last step we have to substitute the point in this value, then only it becomes the slope of the tangent. Okay, after getting the dy by dx value, you have to replace x1 y1 point here in this answer, then only you get the slope of the tangent. That is slope of the tangent is equals to m into y1 power 1 minus y1 power 1 by 3 by x1 power 1 by 3. So this is the slope value. So what is next? What is the next step? We want the equation of the tangent. And what is the equation of the tangent formula? Y minus y1 is equals to m into x minus x1. Okay, this is the equation of the tangent. Now what is x1 y1? X1 y1 means we have the same point x1 y1. That is, there is no change in the point x1 y1. We have the same point here. Now replacing the slope value. Minus y1 power 1 by 3 by x1 power 1 by 3. Into x minus x1. Okay, now we want the simplification. We have to convert this line in the form of the intercept form. So I am taking the simplification like that. First I am separating all the y terms at one side and the x terms at one side. Okay, first I am writing the all the y terms at one side, that is writing this value to this side. Y minus y1 by y1 power 1 by 3. Okay, just I am taking this value to this side is equals to, what are the remaining values here? Minus of x minus x1 by x1 power 1 by 3. Just writing this y term to this side and writing the remaining values here, which implies now separating the denominator. Y by y1 power 1 by 3 minus y1 by y1 power 1 by 3 is equals to minus x by x1 power 1 by 3 minus of minus plus x1 by x1 power 1 by 3. Okay. So separating the denominator, and this is equals to, okay, in the next step I am writing the x term and y term at this side and the constants at the other side. Okay, that is I am converting this x value to this side, that becomes the x1 by x1 x by x1 power 1 by 3. This is minus x by x1 power 1 by 3. Writing this value to this side, that becomes a plus x by x1 power 1 by 3 plus y by y1 power 1 by 3. Okay, next this value, I am taking this one, is equals to x1 by x1 power 1 by 3 plus y1 by y1 power 1 by 3. Okay, writing this constant and this constant. This is the x term, this is the y term, this is the constant, this is the constant. Okay, which implies this is equals to x by x1 power 1 by 3 plus y by y1 power 1 by 3 is equals to, okay, see here, how to take the simplification to this step? This is equals to, so here the powers are, bases are equal. So we have to subtract the powers, a power m by a power n. What is the formula of the a power m by a power n? a power m minus n. I am applying the same formula to this term here. So this becomes x1 power 1 minus 1 by 3. Okay, m minus n. Subtracting the powers value. So this becomes, doing the NCM, 3 minus 1, 2 by 3. That is the simplification of x1 by x1 power 1 by 3 is nothing but x1 power 2 by 3. Okay, this is a power m by a power n. What is the value? A power m minus n, that is x1 power 2 by 3. Okay, by applying the same formula to this one also, this becomes 5 1 power 2 by 3. Okay, 1 minus 1 by 3, that is 2 by 3. But what is this value? At the starting, I take that this value x1 power 2 by 3 plus y1 power 2 by 3 is equals to a power 2 by 3. Okay, at the starting, at the second step, I take this value. One, see all of you. This value is nothing but a power 2 by 3. Okay, since the point px1, y1 lies on this curve, substituting that point in the curve equation, which implies this becomes x by x1 power 1 by 3 plus y by y1 power 1 by 3 is equals to, this total value is nothing but a power 2 by 3. Okay, now what is the question? First, we have to convert this value in the intercept form. That is, we want here one only. That is, writing this value to this side. So this becomes x by x1 power 1 by 3 into a power 2 by 3. Okay, plus 5 by y1 power 1 by 3 into a power 2 by 3. Okay, is equals to 1. Writing this constant to this side. Okay, so see here, this is in the form of the x by a plus 5 by b is equal to 1, which is the equation of the straight line in the intercept form. So comparing this line with x by a plus 5 by b is equals to 1, then what are the values of the a comma b? A is equal to this value, that is x1 power 1 by 3 into a power 2 by 3, and b value is equals to y1 power 1 by 3 into a power 2 by 3. Okay, these two values are nothing but a comma b values. So what is the given question? We want the AB length value. A is equals to formula A comma 0. That is x1 power 1 by 3 into A power 2 by 3 comma 0. And B is equal to 0 comma B. So this is 0 comma. What is B value? Y1 power 1 by 3 into A power 2 by 3. Okay. So what is the given question? Show that the length AB is the constant. So length AB. So AB is equal to, okay, see here, I am taking the distance between these two points. Square root of A minus 0 whole square is equal to A square. 0 minus B whole square is equal to B square. Root over X2 minus X1 whole square plus Y2 minus Y1 whole square. So AB length is nothing but square root of A square plus B square. Okay. What is A value? X1 power 1 by 3 into A power 2 by 3 whole square. Okay. A square plus B square. Y1 power 1 by 3 into a power 2 by 3 whole square, okay, is equals to square root of, this is x1 power 1 by 3 whole square, which means this value becomes x1 power 2 by 3, 1 into 2, into a power 2 2s are 4, a power 2 by 3 whole square means 2 2s are 4, a power 4 by 3, 1 into 2, 2, y1 power 2 by 3, 2 2s are 4, a power 4 by 3. Now taking that a power 4 by 3 common from these two terms here. So this is a power 4 by 3 into x1 power 1 by 3 plus y1, x1 power 2 by 3 plus y1 power 2 by 3 is equals to square root of a power 4 by 3 into, again this value, in place of this value, I am substituting that a power 2 by 3. Okay. At the third step, we are using this condition. We are writing this condition. A power, okay, see here. Bases are equal, adding the powers, 4 plus 2, 6. 6 by 3, that is root over a square. Root over a square is equals to a. But what is a? Constant. Therefore, the length AB is constant and this is the required answer. AB is equals to a means this is the constant. Therefore, the length AB is the constant. That's all. This is the answer. Very easy question, but some lengthy question. That's all. The most important is a question. All of you practice well this question. This is the very, very important question. Okay. In the next video, I will continue the next important essay question. Okay.